Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, I'm Jamie B. Thanks for stopping by. And if you're already subscribed, then welcome back. So in today's video, I will be reviewing the new Jaclyn Hill Morphe Volume 2 palette. I'm also going to be doing a quick look with it. I've done one look and posted it on my TikTok and also on my Instagram, I believe, and my Facebook. It was a pretty bright yellowy purple sunset vibe going on, but today I'm going to do something a little bit different. So if you're excited to see what I come up with and what I think of this palette, then go ahead and just keep watching and we will get right into it. All right, so I know that I have been away for a week. I didn't post anything last week. I've had a lot going on. My family has been sick, and then there was a birthday party this weekend, so I didn't do my live until really late. And then Sunday into Monday, my husband, my 4-year-old, and my 9-year-old all started vomiting, and it's just been a mess. And I do not feel well at all. I haven't started vomiting, so that's a plus, but I've just had like a lot going on, so forgive me for being MIA. I do try to stay like posting on my Instagram, Facebook, and stuff like that, just because it doesn't really take as much time as posting here on YouTube, so I will try not to do that again. But unfortunately, when stuff happens like that, I just have to kind of step away and take care of the family. But I am back and I still don't feel well, but we're gonna go with it. I'm still working on this whole lighting situation, so I know that it's probably brighter than the last video, definitely brighter than the video before that. I'm just trying to get the perfect lighting and I feel like I'm struggling, so just bear with me if my videos seem to be up and down with the lighting. I just want to get the perfect lighting that doesn't wash me out, isn't too white, too bright, but also isn't too dark and dim and doesn't really show the colors of the products and stuff I'm trying to show you. So now that that's all out of the way, we're gonna go ahead and get into this super white palette. This is the Jaclyn Hill Morphe Volume 2 palette. They came out with another palette in 2017, which I also own. And these are just the colors. So in the 2017 palette, I'll actually grab it so I can show you. So this is the original one from the 2017 launch. I did get it when it launched. It came with all of this good stuff. It was 35 shades. And this was the inside. So these colors are pretty neutral, except for like this quad right here. So I don't hate this palette. I think this palette is actually pretty decent, especially if you're not a big makeup person or you don't have a large collection of makeup. I think that this is gonna be really nice for you. I have heard some really unsettling things lately on Twitter and YouTube about this palette. I'm not really into the whole scandal thing. However, it does deal with the makeup and the quality of the makeup, so I will touch base on it just briefly. I was told that the formula has changed, so it's no longer vegan, and it also does not swatch as good and the quality is a lot crappier. So keep that in mind when you go to purchase this one. I'm thinking about picking it up from Ulta just to do a comparison for you guys. So if you wanna see something like that to see if the new one actually is worse, go ahead and comment down below. I know we get kinda caught up, well, bigger YouTubers kinda get caught up in the mainstream of all of it, and you know, sometimes, I'm not saying they're lying, I just feel like sometimes the truth gets lost in there somewhere. I don't know a nice way of saying it, but I would like to see if there is really a difference or if it's just a bunch of over-exaggeration basically. Like I said, I've seen the videos, I've seen all the receipts and all that, but I like to tend to not believe things unless I find out for myself, just because that's, well, you know, how it should be. But our job here on YouTube and Instagram and stuff is to inform you guys. But as always, not only just to inform you, but to also urge you to find out information and do some research on your own. You cannot take just one person's word on YouTube for granted. So again, I don't really get into the scandal stuff. I'm just really interested on the formula of the makeup. So back to this guy. However, I will tell you, this one is definitely gonna be one of my favorite palettes. It's beautiful color wise let's go with that. So this is also a 35 shadow palette, and I believe it did cost me $38. I'll put it here or down below. I do not remember if it's 38 or 39, but it comes with some of the most beautiful shades ever. And it's very pigmented from what I've used so far. I'm a big cranberry, pinky lover. Like, those are my go-to looks, like cranberry, nudie brown looks. So I'm gonna try not to do that. I think I'm gonna be in this realm right here, maybe some pops of yellows just to kind of give a little bit different. But I want it to be an easy, achievable look so you guys can also do it. I don't want to do anything crazy, dramatic, where you're like, well, I don't know how to do that. So we're gonna go in with something super simple and easy, but I will tell you from what I've seen and have swatched, I do really, really like this palette so far, and I 100% like this palette more than the first one. So I know some people, they don't, but for me, I feel like the first one kind of was too bland. Like, it's so many nudes in here. So many nudie, red brick, brownie shades. Like, for it just, you know what I mean? It wasn't bad. The quality of it is really nice. It's just the colors were not doing it for me. I like a palette that pops, and that's what this one does. All right, so I think I know kind of what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna zoom you guys in so you can get a closer look at what I'm doing. All right, so I think I know what I'm gonna do. Not quite sure. We'll go with it. I've been doing, like, really, really been messing around with these monochromatic looks for my Instagram and all that. So I think I'm gonna go along that line. So, like, my lips and stuff will probably match. I think the first color I'm gonna go into, I think I'm gonna do, like, a pink and purple look. I think that's what I'm gonna do with, like, a pop of yellow or orange. So the first one I think I'm gonna go into is gonna be Tipsy Girl, which is this super duper hot pink one. See, so with my lighting, those pinks look pretty similar, but they're not. Like, this one is much darker than this one. Let me turn this ring light down. So if you can see, this one is a much hotter pink than this one. So they look pretty similar, but they're not. And this is like a purple pink. So I don't know why it's coming off like that on camera, but we're gonna go with it. So we're gonna go into Tipsy Girl, and I'm gonna use this ColourPop brush, and this is the E21. And I'm just gonna get some right there. And I've already put down my P. Louise base when I did my brows. And I'm just gonna put it right there in my crease and build up. So I do wanna let you guys know, just like a tip to help you with your shadow when you're blending. The key to the blended out eyeshadow look is to put the color in the crease and blend up. And then you can add more if necessary. Like, obviously I'm going to need more because that is not gonna be enough pink for me. However, you don't wanna put it directly up here and blend it out, because you're gonna run out of space, or it won't look as blended. So now, once you have achieved the blended, beautiful pink look that you're trying to get, we'll go on to the next step. Like I said, this is going to be a fairly simple tutorial that really anybody can follow, I promise. I try to keep a lot of my makeup looks that way, and I put, like, my dramatic ones that I feel are a little bit more advanced just on Instagram. And if anyone wanted to ask me how to do it, then I can always do that. But I usually try to stick to pretty entry-level makeup looks on my YouTube so you guys can learn it and do it on your own. However, with this makeup palette, I have to honestly say that I'm kind of disappointed in how many over-edited, face-tuned looks I've seen. I know I say it all the time. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. But, like, this palette has been brought to the next level of Facetune. It's a beautiful palette. Like, let it do its job on camera with lighting. You don't need to add all that. Like, it is stunning on its own. And it just drives me insane that people are doing that, because it's like, it does not look like that. I own this palette. I've used those colors. Calm down. It does not look like that. So we're gonna go in to the next color, which is a little bit of a more dull shade, which is Lolly Mama. And I'm gonna go ahead and put that in my crease and blend it just a smidge. So if you guys did not see my live, I am currently using the Ordinary skincare brand for 30 days. To kind of just test it out, and then I will give you guys a full-on updated review on what I feel about it. Is it worth it? You know, it's a cheap skincare brand, but does it actually have good quality products? So today is Mark's week one, and I will definitely give you a sneak peek and tell you that I do see improvement on my skin. So stay tuned, 3 more weeks, I'll let you guys know. And then I just got in the mail all this Pixi PR skincare stuff for dry skin. Like, it's all milk-based. So I'm going to be trying that to show you, and we'll go from there. So the next color I'm going to do is going to be the flat brush. But it's going to be this one right here, which is Not My Journey, because she is so beautiful. And this is my journey. Like, that's my color. But because I want that purple to pop as much as possible, I'm going to go in with my white P. Louise base. All right, so now that I went ahead and did that, I'm going to go into that Not My Journey, which is that darker purple. Like, I don't know why it comes off super light on camera in the palette, but this is the purple that it is. So that's very patchy, but I have really dry skin on my hands, so it's pretty dark though. And I'm just going to pat it over that white on the lid, and then we'll blend up after I coat the lid with the purple. Ooh, so pretty. Like, I'm telling you, these colors are so pigmented that Facetune is not needed. Like, these are some bright ass colors. Morphe and Jaclyn did really good on this one. So I'm gonna go in with a tapered brush from Morphe, and I'm just gonna get in here and start to blend her up. Oh, I am blending this. I will do a PSA. It does have a bit of fallout, but you can really expect that in a palette that provides this much pigment. Like, it's very normal. So, but I do want to say that. And also, it stains the eye because of the pressed pigments that are used. So just throwing that out there so no one can say, well, you didn't say that it's staying dry. So I'm gonna go back in with Tipsy Girl and try to blend out some of that purple and put in some of that pink back into the upper part of the eye. So I tried the Big Ego pomade, the Framework Brow Pomade in Black Brown from Tarte. And I will tell you, I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan because I feel like it's way too light. And that's the darkest shade that they own. Like, I had to go through and put some really dark powder on, and I still feel like my brows are much lighter than they usually are. Like, for real. Meh. So, I am not feeling my brows today because of that. So, if you have not bought it, do not. It's just like a thinner consistency than the ABH one. Like, I feel like they tried, but they couldn't get it that thick consistency, so it just doesn't work for me the way that the ABH what does, so I'm just gonna pass on that. Use it for a backup. Alright, and just before we go put the rest of our face makeup on, I'm gonna go ahead and dab some more purple on the lid where we have blended out and kind of gotten rid of a little bit of it. All right, so I'm gonna go off camera. I'm gonna put all my face makeup on, and then I will be right back and we will finish up the bottom and the inner corner. All right, guys, so I have gone ahead and finished my face. Also, I used this beauty blender. I found it at Sephora. It's a beauty blender power pocket puff, dual-sided powder puff. I think it's just for powder, but I thought it was for liquid cream too, so I used it for both. It's really squishy, so I liked it. I feel like it blended out my foundation pretty okay. I don't know, weird. I still haven't gotten the Blendiful by Tati, and I probably won't. Honestly, I just picked it up because I saw it and I was like, oh, that's cute, let's try that. But that's about it. I have been trying like a lot of new stuff lately too. Like, I just used the new Luminous Setting Spray from Morphe. I have no idea how old or new that is, because I definitely didn't even know it was a thing until the other day when I walked by it at the store. So, and I like how it gives my face like a light little glow after I spray it on. All right, so I am gonna go in with that pink underneath, and I'm just going to, actually, I think I'm gonna go in with Therapy Stash because I believe that that is going to match the lipstick I chose the best. Yes, I think that's what I'm doing. Okay, all right, I've decided. All right, so I'm going in with Therapy Stash. Because it's like a pinky purple, so I feel like it's going to be the best to kind of blend it with. That is not my journey brush. That brush was trash. Let's try that again. Feel like it's a little more purple than I expected it. It's fine. So I'm going to go in with Tipsy Girl and just add a little bit of that pink. I'm gonna add that pink and then I'm gonna go in and add just a smidge of Not My Journey, which by the way, I think might have shimmer in it. So now that I'm looking at it, I think it does have like reflex of like little glitter pieces, sparkles. All right, so we're going there with a little of Not My Journey to darken it up so it's not as light. Okay. Ooh. And I'm gonna go in to Talia, which is this super duper gold. Like, it looks like it's a chunky pressed glitter. So we're gonna go in with that one, the inner corner. I was gonna do a yellow, but now I think I'm doing the chunky gold. Faux show. Okay, so I'm gonna take Talia on the brush and I'm just gonna go ahead and put her right here. Ooh, it looks a lot brighter off camera than it does on camera. I hate that. Like, sometimes I feel like you guys don't really get the full effect of some stuff because it doesn't come off as pigmented on the camera, because the camera, if the lighting isn't perfect, which is what I'm trying to work on, it will literally just dull the color down. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and put on my lipstick and then we'll be right back and we will discuss my thoughts on the palette. Okay, so I've tried several different lipsticks on and the one I went with is You Better Work by Jeffree Star Cosmetics. So this is the look that I created. It is a very simple look. I think I used one in like 3 colors. It's a very cohesive and beautiful, like monochromatic purple pink look. I absolutely love it. I do really, really enjoy this palette, guys. I don't think I have swatched a color on here that I am not in love with. You do get all of these. So these right here, here, and to here, and you have some here, are just your neutral browns. So you do have a lot of transition shades. You have a lot of just beautiful, like, nudie pink shimmers. And I'll go ahead and actually swatch some of these for you so you can see, like, how the shimmers work, since I didn't really use any of those. So we'll go ahead and swatch those. Like, they're just very creamy and just very pigmented. Please don't mind the lighting. I think I am gonna have to turn it down because when I do those swatches, it's just not bright at all. I'm gonna go in with My Man, which is that super bright orange. Feeling Myself, which is more of a, I would say My Man is more of a coral orange. Feeling Myself is a true orange. And then Positivity, which is a pinky orange. I'm just gonna go ahead and swatch those for you. Just remember, my hands are pretty dry and these are mattes, so they will stick to those. But they're just, they're stunning colors. Like, honestly, I absolutely positively love this palette. So this is Dance Party, which I've seen a lot of people use, and Livin' My Best, which is super red. So let me pull this down. And they're just, they are beautiful colors. There's look at that red. Oh my God. Like, that swatched really, really bright for a red. A matte red that. Oh my God. And I'm stained. Perfect. So I really just believe that this, if you're going to get one of the Jaclyn Morphe palettes, let it be this one. I don't really care for the first one. It's not that it's bad. It's not that it's great. I'm just like, okay, cool, I have it. But this one, I'm so excited to play with. Like, I can't wait to dig into like this area because that's my jam. Use a little bit of these, some of these, some of these. So I'm just really excited to use these. The pigments on these shadows is just crazy phenomenal. Like, I want to go one more, which is going to be that yellow shade, which is no joke. Literally, that's what the shade is called. But also, seriously, look at that swatch. That's all I'm saying. That's a yellow. That is a yellow eyeshadow that just swatched like butter across my dry hand and is super pigmented. So I honestly 100% think that this is gonna be the palette you should pick if you haven't gotten a Jaclyn Morphe palette, or if you haven't gotten a Morphe palette, which I find hard to believe, but if not, this is definitely gonna be the one. I love the colors. I love that you have the nudes and you can have the brights, but you can also have just your smoky, pretty traditional cranberry colors. But if you wanna throw a poppin' yellow in there, or orange or hot pink, it's there. I absolutely love this palette. I would recommend this palette to anybody, and I think it's very affordable. It's huge. I mean, it's not as big as like the James Charles palette, but it's a pretty big palette for $38. So I definitely have to give this palette two big thumbs up. I absolutely love it. I hate that it's white because it's already dirty. But other than that, I really can't find any negatives in this palette. The colors blend well, they're pigmented, you get so much color payoff. There is slight fallout and slight staining, but again, all things that you're gonna find in very, very pigmented shadows, so keep that in mind. So if you guys have this palette, go ahead and let me know down below what your favorite color is in it. If you don't have it, do you plan on getting it? I do have to say, it's gonna be one of my favorite in my collection now, hands down. The colors are so pretty. They're way more than I expected. Like, I just expected it to be like an okay palette. Like, this, it blew me away. It absolutely blew me away, and I absolutely love it. I love all of it, and I can't wait to play with it more. Like, hands down. Look at my fingers though, stained. So if you guys like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up, and as always, I love you. I will see you on the next one. Go ahead and comment down below and let me know your thoughts on the Jaclyn Hill Volume 2 palette, and tag me in some looks that you do. Bye!